إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال: جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال: يا رسول الله، الرجل يحب القوم ولا يلحق بهم، ما تقول في الرجل يحب القوم ولا يلحق بهم؟ عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه يقول: إذا man came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and he asked him, he said, what do you say about a person who loves others, يعني he loves someone or loves a group of people or just individuals, but he doesn't catch up with them? Meaning, I love someone righteous, but I don't catch up with him with my good deeds. يعني he does a lot more than me, or he's closer somehow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than me, but I love that person. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم: المرء مع من يحب. The person will be united with the one he loves. And that's why we focus so much on friendship. And we focus so much on those you love and you associate yourself with. And those people who are so attached to celebrities or sports figures or something like that, where they spend their time reading about them and watching them and doing all of those things, and it will be a regret the day of judgment. Because in the ayah in Surah Al-Shuhara, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَا لَهُمْ مِنْ شَافِعِينَ وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ. They don't have intercessors, talking about the people of the hellfire, and they don't have a good friend. Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah was asked, what is the meaning of وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ? They don't have a good friend. فقال رضي الله عنه, which is really what he answered them is also in a hadith, he said, قال يسأل الرجل الله سبحانه وتعالى عن فلان, يعني عندما يخلص المؤمنون إلى الجنة ويخلص الكافرون أو أهل النار إلى النار, يسأل الرجل الله سبحانه وتعالى عن فلان. When finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala judges amongst people, and people of Jannah go to Jannah, people of hellfire go to hellfire, when in the Jannah person would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where is so and so? He doesn't see that person there. فَيُقَالُ لَهُ فِي النَّارِ. Then the answer is, he's in hell. فَيَقُولُ يَا رَبِّ لا تكمل لذتي إلا بفلان. He says, oh Allah, my pleasure in Jannah is not complete unless I have this man with me. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise us complete satisfaction and you can ask what you want? So he said, I'm not going to be happy without that person. فيقول الله سبحانه وتعالى له: اذهب فأخرج. Go and get him out. فيذهب. So he goes and then he gets him out. Then أهل النار يقولون: من هذا؟ The people of the hellfire, من هذا؟ أخوه شهيد. أخوه شهيد. Who got him out? Is his father a شهيد or his brother a شهيد? فيقال: كان صاحبه فلان صالح. Then it would be said, this is his righteous friend, so and so. The scholar said from this, Even if you associate yourself with a righteous person one time, it will benefit you the day of judgment in a situation like this. Because the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so big that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivers anyone from hellfire who's got just an atom seed or a mustard seed size faith in his heart. And this hadith also, for people who know people or met people at least once, they will remember in the day of judgment. And I'm talking about people who met one another righteous. It's not just an acquaintance. But you met that person, you attended a lecture, you sat with him, you talked about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or something to them, and that is beneficial for you the day of judgment, inshallah. We learn from this hadith that the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you love someone, you may not be as righteous as that person. But because you love him, because he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this love, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises your rank higher to be with those people. Imagine, same thing, came to a companion, came and complained to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he told him the same thing. He said, I cannot basically function when I go home. I can't wait until I come and see you. And today I was thinking, you're going to be way up there, and I'm going down here. So yes, I am in Jannah, but I love you so much, I want to be with you. Then he told him the same thing. Anta ma'a man tuhib. You will be with the one you love, and that is an honor to always seek the company and the friendship of a righteous person, and to look and see how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, when he elevates your status with something you don't deserve, all just for your sincere love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something that we should care for too much, inshaAllah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.